الحج أشهر معلومات فمن فرض فيهن الحج فلا رفث ولا فسوق ولا جدال في الحج وما تفعلوا من خير يعلمه الله وتزودوا فإن خير الزاد التقوى واتقون يا أولي الألباب.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. ما بعد, we are doing various good deeds, especially during these 10 days of Dhul Hijjah, where we can, insha'Allah ta'ala, come close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And of course, these good deeds can be done in any days, but just a reminder that especially during these 10 days, one of the easiest good deeds, in some ways the easiest, one of the easiest, and yet it is so difficult, is the good deed of mastering one's akhlaq, one's manners, one's adab with other human beings. And this is a manifestation of a tenderness and a compassion of the heart and a realization of loving for your brother what you love for yourself. This concept of having good akhlaq, it is something that the Quran and Sunnah is full of. There are so many dozens of ayat and hadith about the blessings of having good akhlaq. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the Quran that the real worshippers of Allah are those who walk with humility on this earth. And when people want to have fights with them and accost them and insult them, they say salama and they move on. So Allah mentions that the true worshippers of Allah are humble, compassionate, and forgiving. And our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he told us that good manners are of the most comprehensive blessings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can give to any person. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that people have not been given anything better than good manners. People have not been given anything better than husn al-khuluq. And he said in another hadith that alayka bi husn al-khuluq, I advise you to have good manners and also advise you to be silent for long periods of time. For I swear by the one in whose hands is my soul, the creation is not beautified by anything better than this. You want to really beautify yourself, beautify your inner before you beautify your outer. Our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying the real beauty is the beauty of manners. And in fact, a lot of people, they think that the righteous person is the one whose outer manifestations are supposedly religious, or the one who is always, you know, outwardly praying, the one who is, yani mashallah, the sunnah beard is there and this and that, so they judge. And I'm not saying that's wrong, okay, these are all aspects. But what did our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam say? He said in the authentic hadith that a righteous Muslim can achieve the level of the one who fasts continuously and the level of the one who does tahajjud continuously without fasting and doing tahajjud simply by having good manners. Now think about that, right? A man who wakes up 2 hours every single night, a man who fasts every single second day, or 3 days of the week, or you know, regularly, right? And you would think, mashallah, this man is so pious, and he is pious. But what if he doesn't have good akhlaq? What if he's crude and rude? What if he's obnoxious and mean? Our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, as long as you're doing your 5 prayers, as long as you're doing the bare minimum, and you have good akhlaq with the rest of humanity, you can reach the level of that other person who is constantly praying every night the tahajjud prayer, and constantly fasting above and beyond the fast of Ramadan, and indeed that is something good that he's doing, but because he doesn't have akhlaq, your good akhlaq can match up to and maybe even surpass that person. Imagine how powerful akhlaq can be, and how much beloved they are to Allah, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves the person of good akhlaq and will grant him the status of the one who doesn't have good akhlaq, but the one who is praying tahajjud at night, every single night of the year he's praying tahajjud, and the one with good akhlaq is sleeping the night. But Allah will grant him the status of that person simply by having good akhlaq. And that is why it is a sign of iman to have good akhlaq. Our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, and this is a very simple hadith, you'll understand the Arabic, أكمل المؤمنين إيمانا أحسنهم خلقا. أكمل كمال. أكمل المؤمنين إيمانا. That's the believers that have the most perfect iman. So they have the kamal al-iman, are those who have the best of all manners. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam explicitly linked good manners with the perfection of iman. I cannot be more blunt here. If you don't have good manners, you don't have good iman. This is explicit from the hadith. And if you have good manners, that is definitely an indication, not the only one, because you can have good manners and your iman is weak, but it is an indication that it is check. See, here's the point. Good manners is an essential part of having good iman, but there are more components as well, right? You must also be having some rituals as well. Now, if you don't have good manners and you have the rituals, you also do not have iman as well. So we have to be very clear here that good manners is one essential component of having strong iman. But if you do not have good manners and you have the rituals, you do not have good iman. And if you have good manners but you don't have any rituals, no salah, no zakah, that is a major problem as well. And that is why they have to go hand in hand. So our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam explicitly told us that the people of good iman have good manners, the people of strong iman have strong manners, and the people of weak iman, they have bad manners. And there's no surprise, therefore, that our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that Allah is beautiful and He loves beauty, and He loves the best of akhlaq, and He despises the crude and the debased of akhlaq. Allah loves the best of akhlaq. Those people that have the best manners, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves them. And those people that have the worst of manners, Allah does not love them. In fact, in one hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that Allah hates the one whose mouth is always vulgar, and the one who's always cursing, and the one who's always putting people down. That the word used is Allahu yubghid. Allah hates the one who is fahish al mutafahish al badhi, like always just nasty people to be around. And may Allah protect us. We all know people like that, right? SubhanAllah, that wherever you around them is just going to be something bad, something negative, putting somebody down, just the vulgarities. You don't want to be around that person. And our Prophet ﷺ said, it's not just you. Nobody wants to be around that person. And SubhanAllah, it is even possible that Allah Azza wa Jalla does not like that person. It's very careful then. We have to be careful about making sure that, you know, we don't have these types of characteristics. On the Day of Judgment, our Prophet ﷺ said that the heaviest of things on the scales of the Day of Judgment will be good manners. The heaviest of things. So if all items are placed out there, what will be the heaviest item? We need to have salah, no question. We need to have zakah, no question. What is going to be the heaviest? It is going to be a lifestyle that exudes compassion and kindness and mercy and genuine good cheer to the people around us. To be a person who's smiling and comforting and sympathetic and cheerful, cheering other people up, giving positive encouragements, treating, you know, people, instead of treating an evil person in an evil manner, treat them in a good manner. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that that is going to be the heaviest matter on the scales of the Day of Judgment. Now, we talked a little bit about the blessings of akhlaq. What is good akhlaq? What is good manners? Well, in reality, this is a reality, as our scholars say, that to define it is problematic because everybody knows what it is. That which is known does not need to be defined, is another saying, right? That which is well known should not and cannot be defined. Everybody knows what good manners are. Good manners is to show happiness and contentment and cheerfulness and to be helpful to others and to control one's own anger, right? So to treat others better than what you would want to be treated, and to take from them, right, whatever they are doing with the best of manners as well. And so you can get shortchanged by other people, but you should not shortchange other people, okay? So good manners is that you give more than what it is due, and that you're willing to receive less than your due, and to be of someone who has a genuine compassion and a kind heart. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also explicitly says humility, hauna. He mentions in the Quran that those that are believers, that they have a sense of humility and modesty. You cannot have good manners if you have a sense of arrogance. Now, before we finish today's talk, we should very quickly point out that our scholars say that There are three types of manners. The first is manners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The second is manners with the creation of Allah. And the third is manners with one's own self. And each one has long topic in and of itself. Manners with Allah means you think the best thoughts about Allah, you're remembering Allah, doing dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you're conscious of the limits of Allah. Manners with other people is what we have been talking about. Manners with yourself is that you yourself in your own personal lifestyle, you should be giving manners to yourself as well, treating your body with dignity, for example, giving the body its due right. Do not abuse, things that are going to harm your own body. That's a manners with your own body. So these are the three categories of manners. And of course, the talk today was primarily about the issue of manners with the other makhluqat of Allah, creation of Allah. And the most important group of people that deserve your manners are your immediate family. And so inshallah, we will talk about that in our next lecture. I will see you then. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
وَاذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ فِي أَيَّامٍ مَعْدُودَاتٍ فَمَنْ تَعَجَّلَ فِي يَوْمَيْنِ فَلَا إِثْمَ عَلَيْهِ وَمَنْ تَأَخَّرَ فَلَا إِثْمَ عَلَيْهِ لِمَنِ اتَّقَى وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَاعْلَمُوا أَنَّكُمْ إِلَيْهِ تُحْشَرُونَ.